Okay, so hi there, Capricorn Sun, Moon, and Rising Sign. This is Chrissy from In the Stars by Chrissy.com, and this is going to be your June 2021 Love Monthly Forecast reading. So, we did not really get to see what happened to you last month because, you know, that was during the time of the Mercury retrograde shadow period, and I was having a lot of technical difficulties. I do apologize for that, and that's actually quite the reason why I started late, you know, into the signs that I have missed out during the month of May. So yeah, without any further ado, let's go down to business, and we are going to be taking a look on what are the influences that might be happening for you personally and in terms of your relationship and love life situation. So please do know that this is going to be a general reading, so it may or may not tune into each and every Capricorn people out there. So yeah, just keep that in mind. Anyways, without any further ado, let's go into the first card of this reading, and you have here the Five of Wands. And the Five of Wands has a form of friction, and it's really more an element wherein there is some form of chaos. And in this reading, this is really more of a situation wherein maybe you are at the state of mind right now wherein you are wanting to do something, some form of change into your life, but for some reason there's a lot of hesitation that has been going on with you, and it's being crossed over by the Two of Wands as well. And this makes me feel like, you know, maybe are you choosing between two parties, or are you choosing between two people? I kind of feel that, you know, this is really more of a situation wherein something has definitely occurred in the past. And, you know, maybe you have some form of trauma in the past, or there are some form of regrets, or there are some form of fears that are going on right there. And the reason for that is we have here the Five of Swords, and the Five of Swords usually, you know, something is bogging our head, something is bogging our mind, you know. There's something that maybe is unsettling, and, you know, maybe you are seeking answers, but you're not actually, you know, having any form of conclusion. There is nothing fixed, there is nothing that is very certain, there's nothing that is really making you feel secure in life right now. And this can also talk about some form of argument. Again, this is a general reading, so what I'm actually giving you guys are really more on various information and how this can actually play out. So yeah, the foundation of this reading, you have here the King of Wands, and at the top of the reading you actually have here the Four of Swords. And this is really more of a situation wherein, you know, what it is that is going on inside of you right now is something that people don't know, you know. I kind of feel that maybe, you know, outside with your physical appearance, with how you show yourself to the world, you are not actually telling people that you are bothered about something. So there is something that's going on in you right now wherein you are keeping it as a secret. Maybe there is a lot of revelations that's going on with you. Maybe there's a lot of reflections of what has happened in the past, and, you know, you are slowly trying to put the pieces up together again. And with the Four of Swords, this gives me an element wherein this could be a time wherein you are going to be reflecting things in your life, or this can also be an element wherein you are praying and thinking about the situation, finding answers into certain things in your life, but you don't want to make other people think or believe that it's actually bothering you. So at one point of our life, we are seeing some form of ego work that is happening here, and there's nothing really wrong with that, especially if maybe this is about you as a man, probably, or maybe you're dealing with a man wherein you had some form of argument with them, and, you know, maybe you think that they're very, very cold, they don't really budge no matter what you do, but deep inside of them, in their heart, they're actually quite bothered. And if they have hurt you, this is really more of a situation that they are actually thinking about, that they are, you know, should I do something? Should I apologize? You know, there's something that is quite unsettled right there. And in case this occurs for you in a very personal level or professional life, this can also be a situation wherein, you know, maybe there was something that is not working out into your life, into your relationships, or into your career even. And you are at the point of your life wherein you want to make things right. And this is really what I feel into this reading. This is all about wanting to improve these circumstances and wanting to make things right, finally, you know, that kind of thing. And in our near future, we have here the Empress card. And the Empress card is actually create really more of a wonderful thing when it comes to in the near future kind of sense. It could be that a woman or a particular person in your life is going to create some form of shakeup because of a particular person that is going to bring some form of good change and opportunity in your life that is full of bounties, full of opportunities and happiness all at the same time. So it makes you feel that, you know, there's something that's really, really nice. There's something that's really, really good out there for you. And, you know, I kind of feel that this is all about new beginnings all at the same time. And while we are seeing that as a good possibility, we also should not forget that we are at the middle of a retrograde. So if there is some form of wonderful offer that's being presented to you right now, I kind of feel that, you know, you need to think about it very carefully, especially if it is something completely new and completely something that you have never done before. And as a Capricorn person, I kind of feel that, you know, you are usually very cautious and very much of a safe person. You don't usually risk things, but we do have a lot of things going on astrologically, so I'm just trying to warn you guys to make sure that you do not do something that you are eventually going to regret. We also have here the Page of Cups as the a card that represents you as well. So this is really more of a situation wherein you are willing to give chances. You're willing to offer some form of help as well. This is really more of a situation wherein if in the past you seemed very much close-minded, you're not really willing to make some form of adjustments, this is really more of a time wherein you are feeling flexible maybe. And you are, you know, willing to take a look on certain things in your life on another angle, which is a really wonderful thing, really positive thing. So you're not really more rigid-minded, and maybe this was the month wherein you were able to settle down, you're able to think more, you're able to reflect on your own actions and the things that you have done in your life, basically, or in your relationships, especially when we're dealing with your love affairs. And you have here the Three of Wands as well, so maybe there's something that you're actually looking forward to. I don't know if you guys are looking into the past or into the future, but whenever we see the Three of Wands, it's definitely looking somewhere. And, you know, it's not as if they have already attained what it is that they want, but there is a form of planning, you know, looking into the distance, looking where things are heading. So this could be a situation wherein you're thinking of the next step that has to be done in your relationship, whether it is about you settling down or whether it is a relationship that has been broken apart and you wanted to fix it. It really depends. We do have here the Nine of Wands though, and this is really what is it gives us a highlight of a situation wherein there was something that you're really hesitating upon, really being really guarded on. So I kind of feel that for the longest time, you yourself have not really taken any action. Maybe you have been waiting far too long, or this can also be a situation wherein there is something that is making me feel tired one way or another, or you are at the last straw of a stick. And maybe if there is some form of ego work wherein two people are trying to be hard-headed, I kind of feel this is going to be a time wherein someone is going to fall apart. And I'm not saying that in a negative way, because basically what I'm trying to say is that, you know, if two people are too stubborn, this is going to be a month wherein someone is definitely going to give in, and there's going to be a conclusion because of that. And maybe if you are, you know, not willing to lower your head, maybe this is going to be the time wherein you're not going to be too cold-hearted about the situation, and you would want to take action. You would want to do something into the situation, basically, to soften things out. This is really what I see here. Really softening things out. It's not about the ego. It's about the feelings. It's about what truly matters and what it is that you truly want to achieve in this situation. And maybe you are going to come into a conclusion of what is really worth it at the end of the day, right? So, at the outcome of this reading, we have here the Eight of Wands, and the Eight of Wands has a lot to do with a lot of unexpected things. You know, things can happen in a high speed rate, basically, and you can basically expect things to change and expect things to be unexpected, basically. And I really see this more of a good thing, because as we look into your past and your present situation, things are really, really stagnant. So, despite how we are seeing a lot of changes and opportunities that's going to be happening for you, we should see this as a wonderful thing, because maybe this is really what you needed, the shakeup that you really needed, you know? And what you thought was very complicated, you know, there could be a realization that it's not complicated at all. Why did I make that so complicated to begin with? So there is a chance here wherein some form of opportunities can lead to some form of success, especially when your guard has lowered down, and especially when communication arises. And because we do see that there's going to be some form of communication and trying to work things out, there's going to be change that is going to be wonderful. Some form of action is going to be done, some form of change, and there's going to be improvement in the process with all of this. And you know, you are all about keeping things to yourself, and you're not seeing the process of communication, and expression is going to be a big deal as well. We do have here some form of Lenormand cards, as I usually do whenever I end the reading. And funny enough, I didn't really realize it earlier. I was saying earlier about the Capricorn man, and we have here the man, right? So maybe it is really talking about, you know, a particular man in this reading, whether it's you or another person. So it seems here that you have a relationship with someone that has some form of connection to you, some form of foundation into your life, you know, someone very important as well. Maybe your relationship has no conclusion, has no answers, or maybe, you know, there is some form of gap between your feelings. You know, I kind of feel that there is not much intimacy or not much connection, or I feel that there could have been a wall between you and another person. And this is really more of a time wherein, oddly enough, you are going to see some form of improvement and some form of changes when it comes to your relationships as well. And you are going to see that this person is going to be a lot more open to you, a lot more accommodating to you. They are really, you know, they are really going to be nicer and really more emphatic in one way or another. There's a form of sensitivity in them. And so basically we're seeing here that there's going to be a lot of opportunities that is going to be presented to you, and things might actually progress and move to another stage, you know, some form of improvement. But then again, let us be reminded that we are in a retrograde area. So when there is a retrograde, basically, we should not, you know, go immediately into an official relationship. You guys can talk, you guys can improve your connection, you guys can, you know, can flirt around, enjoy the moment, have some form of conversations, get closer together and all those kinds of things. But don't make your relationship official yet, or don't make any form of a very important life-changing situation in your love life and relationships, because as soon as the retrograde of Mercury ends, you know, that can create some form of conflict and suddenly changing of minds. And, you know, this is really more of a time where we should build things up to improve the situation, not in making things final, but allowing us to really explore our own feelings, our own creativity, our own connection towards one another. So do not be afraid to talk to people. Do not be afraid to express what it is that you truly feel. And I kind of feel that for the big part of a lot of people, you know, expressing their own feelings is going to be a very big thing. And not just for Capricorn as well, but for a lot of people, you know, relationship is going to be a big topic. And yeah, if you haven't listened to my podcast, I do have a podcast wherein I did talk about this based on the eclipse that has recently happened all at the same time. So anyway, thank you guys for watching and tuning in with me again. I do apologize for last month, and I do hope that this reading has given you insight and clarity to the situation. It is a very positive reading, so I'm pretty excited how things are going to pan out for you guys. Yeah, do let me know. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, like this video, and maybe comment down below if it resonates with you, or if something happens to you within this month. Who knows, right? And if you do want to book a reading with me, you can do that by booking a session through my website in the starsbychrissy.com. And yeah, or you can always email me at inthestarsbychrissy@gmail.com as well. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I shall see you guys again next month. Bye.